Good morning, Sairam students. Hope that you all are fine and you all are studying at home. You all must have completed your written work. If not, then complete it and try to revise the chapter again and again to learn them thoroughly. So, in the last video, we have started with a new chapter, chapter 3 of New Voices, that is The Meeting Pool by Ruskin Bond. The Meeting Pool by Ruskin Bond is about three friends named Anil, Somi and Rusty. And we also know that Rusty is the narrator of this story. Who is the narrator? Rusty. Why he is known as narrator? Narrator is the person who tells us the story of his life and about his friends. And here we know that Rusty is telling the story about his friends and about the pool. In the last video, we have seen that Rusty has discovered a pool in the forest. And all these friends have promised each other to meet there after 10 years. That they have decided that in the month of April, we will meet near that pool. Wherever we are, wherever we will be, but we will come here to meet each other. They took pledge on that pool, and now let us see, did they come to meet each other after 10 years? So let us start with today's video with the explanation. So the next paragraph says that it didn't really matter how muddy we got, because we had only to dive into the pool to wash off the mess. So the last video we saw that they all were playing with the buffaloes on the pool, and they now here Rusty is saying that we didn't care that how much muddy means when we are covered with the mud, with the dust. We are not worried about to be muddy, because at last we have to take dive in the pool to just wash all the mud that is on our body. If it was possible to get out of our houses undetected at night, we would come to the pool and bathe by moonlight. So in the next lines, Rusty says that if it is possible for us to move out of our house at night, we try to come out of our houses at night without catching by our parents, and we bathe in the pool at midnight under the moonlight. We bathe silently because the stillness and airiness of the surrounding jungle seem to discourage high spirit. So here he says that at night we didn't shout there at the pool. We just try to take bath very calmly, very silently, because if we will shout, the wild animals will get disturbed and they will come there. We saw several snakes which came out to feed on the frogs that spent the summer nights in full-throated songs. So here Rusty is telling that at night when we are taking bath in the pool, we sometimes saw the snake. Sometimes we saw that snake came to the pool to eat the frogs that are making very irritating noise by singing songs. An immense owl occasionally watched us from the branch of a big sal tree. So here he was saying that at night when we are taking bath, we used to see that an owl which is sitting on a sal tree. Sal is a tree, name of a tree. So he says, at times I have seen that owl which is sitting on the sal tree used to watch us from the branch. Sometimes Somi would sing in a deep pleasant voice, and we would float magnolia blossoms down the moonlight stream. So here he says that at times it happened that Somi used to sing song in a very beautiful voice, and we used to float in the water. Now move to the next paragraph. It says that I don't remember how we finally broke up. So here he is telling that at last it happened that we all get separated. How they get separated? Let us see that. It was hardly noticeable at the time. So it was impossible for Rusty to believe that all the friends were separated. In spite of our pledge to return to the pool as grown men, we never really believed that we would go different ways, that we would be leaving the pool. So he says that though we have taken the pledge that we will meet at the pool after 10 years, but I was not sure that it will happen to me that we all will get separate before that only. So it was very difficult for Rusty to believe that all the friends separated. The group of three friends was separated. It broke up finally. How? Because after one year, Somi has passed his exam, that is for military, and he went to the military school. And after 3 years of that, he saw Somi with a military mustache and with a very stern body. Shortly after Somi left school, Anil and his family went away to Delhi. So what happened when Somi went to the military school? He left the school there. Anil also went to Delhi with his family, and Rusty never see Anil again. Though he has seen Somi after 3 years with a mustache, but Anil didn't come back to the village again. He went to Delhi forever. So now here Rusty says that I could not visualize Anil in any conventional occupation. He said, I cannot think that Anil will do any serious work because he was very wild. He was unpredictable. Nobody knows what he will do. And yet sometimes I wondered, those who are rather wild when they are young often grow up to be respectable people. He says that it is very true that those child who are very naughty in their childhood, they grow up as a very respectable people in their young time. And those who are very quiet in their childhood, they became very naughty in their young age. Now, the next paragraph says that, and what of the pool and our pledge to come back after 10 years? So now here Rusty is talking to himself. What will happen to our pledge? Will they come back to the pool to meet me after 10 years? Now he says that in April, I happened by chance to be in the same part of the country. So here he says that it happened by chance that I was in the village, in the part of that country that I came to that, that I came by chance to that country. So I decided that I at least would keep my part of the pledge. So he said, though they will come or not, I don't know, but I should keep my pledge. I should keep the part of my pledge that yes, I went to that pool, I waited for you, but you didn't come. So he decided that I will go to the pool to keep my pledge, to keep my promise. I will go to the pool. Now he says that I could not found the pool. After so many years, it was impossible for Rusty to find the pool at that place. But there was no water. There was no water in the only there was ravine and a bed of shingle. What is ravine? Ravine means it is smaller. It is big than gully and smaller than a valley. So it is middle part of valley and gully. That is known as ravine. A very you can see a shrink part of a valley, that is known as ravine. That a very not a big thing like a valley, but it's bigger than a gully. That is known as ravine. So there was lot of shingles there, the stones were there, water was flowing, but not that much water which was at which was before 10 years, but it was now a ravine. It was not a valley, not a pool now, but there was no water. The stream had changed its course just as we had changed ours. So he says the water has changed its path the same way we three friends have changed our path. Now the next paragraph says that I waited in the ravine for 2 or 3 hours. So Rusty is saying that I waited there for my friends for 3 to 2 hours, but nobody came there. I suppose it was foolish of me to expect anyone. So he says that it might be my foolishness that I am waiting for my friends. Though we have taken this pledge in our childhood, it might happen that they have forgotten this pledge to meet at the pool after 10 years, and I am very foolish that I came to keep the part of my promise to meet my friends after 10 years. Somi must have been with his unit, Anil occupied with the business of living. Probably they both had families. Now Rusty is trying to console himself. He tried to convince himself that it might happen that they both are busy in their own life. They both have their own families and they are busy in them, and that's why they forgotten to meet here at the pool after 10 years. I was the only one who hadn't really grown up. He says, I think I am the one who really grown up. The child in me was still there to meet my friend, but I think they both have their family. They have grown up now and they must be so much busy in their life that they have forgotten the pledge to meet at the pool after 10 years. I turned away disappointed and with a dull ache in my heart. So here he says that Rusty is telling that Rusty is telling that I was very disappointed. I thought that might my friends have come to meet me here after 10 years. They might also miss me the same way I miss them so much. The way I miss my childhood, they might be missing them. They might be missing that too. But it didn't happen. And that's why he was very disappointed. His heart was paining. There was a very dull pain in his heart because of this incident, that his friends didn't remember to come there at the pool after 10 years. Friends and daydreams and even forest pool must succumb to the inexorable, deceitful journey of time. So here he says that that friends and daydreams, they are very deceitful. Deceitful means who ditch us, on which we cannot trust. So they are such a things on which we cannot trust. So friends and daydreams are not trustworthy. They will deceive you one day. Now the last paragraph says that, but I hadn't gone far when I heard the splashing of water and the shouting of boys, and pushing my way through a thicket, I found another stream and another pool and half a dozen boys splashing about in the water. So here he says that when I was going back to my home, I heard the splashing of water and some boys were shouting there. When I went there, I hid myself under the shadow of a tree and I saw that there were half a dozen boys, that is 6 boys were there, who were playing in the water, who were bathing in the water. He says that Rusty is saying that they didn't see me. That the boys who were playing in the water, they were not able to see me because I have hidden myself under the shadow of the tree and I was watching them, but I also can't see them very carefully because my vision was of Somi and Anil. That now he is trying to say that I am not seeing that 6 boys who were playing in the water. I am seeing my childhood in that. I was seeing my friend Anil and Somi there, who were playing with the buffaloes in their childhood. I was just imagining that childhood again in those boys. and there I stood for an hour. So he's saying that I was stand there for an hour. I was watching that, but at last it was I always felt disheartened because that so at last he is saying that I stand there for an hour and I was just imagining my childhood, and a child in me has started again to play in that secret pool, in the shallows of that secret pool. So this was your chapter, The Meeting Pool by Ruskin Bond. I hope that you have understood the explanation of the chapter. If not, please repeat the video again and again and try to understand the chapter. Take care of yourself. Thank you, students.